Today, we're going to take a look at all the system components inside of the RPS 400N. For this system, it's okay to use a blade to open the box. As with all of our systems, you will find the full color user manual on the top. Reference this manual when installing your pump. After that, you'll find the pump wire splicing kit. The next item is the field replaceable helical rotor mechanism. Note, this is an extra piece and should only be taken out of its bag in the chance that you need to replace your helical motor. Next, you'll find two separate individual lengths of 100 feet of sensor wire for your tank full and low well sensors. Next, we have 20 feet of solar wire with MC4 connectors on both ends. Now we'll take a look at the plumbing that comes with the kit. Two hose clamps and your hose barb. In the next bag, you'll find your grounding lug along with four self-tapping screws. You'll also have an additional splice kit for your sensors. Now moving our box to the side, we'll take a look at the star of the show, the 400N helical pump. The 2-inch stainless steel pump is housed inside of a very safe protective bubble wrap. Off of the top of the pump, you can find the pump wires. This will go into your controller, and near the middle, you'll find the inlet screen. The final piece of the kit is the RPS Universal Controller.
If you have any solar questions, leave them in the comments below, and they'll be featured in a future video, or we'll answer them in the comments. Be sure to like and subscribe. We're producing new content every week, so hit that notification button and subscribe to the videos to stay up to date on the latest solar pumping news.